Yep. Time to bleed. All right. What is up, everybody? Ooh. Welcome to day 100 and something. It's Monday. Monday morning. That's all that matters. We're gonna back out of the garage here. Get going with this car ride off to the gym for first training. Yeah. It's gonna be a deadly day. I make some good girls go bad. Okay. We are off to the gym here for first of two beautiful trainings today. Hopefully in the title, it's all six events. Hopefully I'm still able to stick with it. Yeah, the goal is to hit all six events again today, tomorrow, and every day till day's end. Yeah. You know, some people say, too hard on myself. So the way I train and how hard I work, you know, like, I guess technically you're right, but like, to get to where I'm trying to go, can't be easy on myself. It's not an easy goal to achieve, so you can't really take the easy route. And where I'm at now, because of how hard I am on myself, it's not always, you know, fun, sunshine and rainbows. Most days aren't fun. Most days suck, you know? If you don't know this, I don't say it in every single video, but I wake up at 3 a.m. every single morning. When that alarm clock goes off at 3 a.m., I'm not sitting there thinking, oh, this is gonna be a great day. No, I'm sitting there like, this pillow feels like a cloud, and I could lay here forever, but I still get out of bed every morning, 3 a.m. I feel like lots of people always say, oh, you're so hard on yourself because, you know, what I'm doing is really misunderstood by most people. Now, most people, they can somewhat understand what I'm doing in a sense of like, hey, he's trying to achieve this goal and he has to work really hard for it, but no one sees all the little things that go in between that, which I'm trying to show you like the most part of it, but like there's still so much more that goes on after and before these videos that I'm doing to try and get better at the sport. But like for the most part, most people can, or pretty much everyone that's watching these videos understands what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. That's why you're watching. But like for the people who, you know, don't watch and kind of hate in a way, not fully hateful, but just kind of not fully supportive of what I'm doing, it's just hard for them to understand what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. And if you're someone out there that's trying to achieve a big goal, it's just something crazy to most people, and then you're trying to achieve it in your life, you know, understand that lots of people are not gonna understand what you're trying to do, and that's good. If everyone understands what you're trying to do and why you're trying to do it and why you're trying to achieve it, and everyone's like, oh, that's good for you, I know why you're doing that, yeah, like I can fully understand it, you gotta work a little harder there then. Unless what you're doing is something that you want to do and it's like your goal, then it's fine. But if you're trying to do something crazy and the point of what you're doing is to do something amazing and everyone's just able to understand it, and it's not amazing enough. But as long as whatever you're doing it because you want to do it, then that's good. But along this nasty, gross road to your success of whatever journey you're on, you will be very much misunderstood because you're going to be so, you know, obsessed. And you got to be obsessed with whatever you're doing to achieve it. You can't just go at it all la-di-da. You got to work extremely hard, put an extreme amount of hours in. And this whole motivational talk I'm giving you right now, it's probably for like maybe two people out there that are watching this video. Out of all the people that watch, probably, I'm hoping there's, you know, a couple of you out there that are trying to achieve something really crazy, and what I'm saying can kind of help you push towards it. Because maybe you're going through that point where, you know, most don't seem to understand what you're doing and why you're doing it. Just understand that that's a good thing. Just know that whatever you're trying to achieve in your life, anyone out there that's trying to achieve that same thing, you're all going through the same hardship, you know, you're all in the same boat. So just know that you're not alone in this path to success. But yeah, hopefully whatever you're going through, trying to achieve, I hope you achieve it. You know, sometimes when I get to the gym here, I feel like my whole car ride talk was a bunch of nonsense and me just rambling on about random stuff, not really getting any sort of point across. So hopefully I got my point across in this car ride. But anyways, we're at the gym, the red zone, the dead zone, the kill zone, the war zone, okay? Let's get to work, shall we? All right, handstand conditioning. Let's get started. Okay, now for pirouettes. Oh. we got three my good way, three my bad way, like I already just did. And then three reverse, my good way and bad way. And then the one bars, fun. Nice. Made five that time. We only made like three last week of the swing to one bar ones, not the, yeah, you know what I mean. Okay, Japanese handstands. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Straight to heaven. Yep. Nice. Yeah. Okay. That's the handstand conditioning. Let's go to vault.
All right, time for vault. So today, well, yesterday, I guess. But today, Yanni, okay, so yesterday, Yanni sent me some texts. He's a gymnast from Toronto. He's in Nebraska right now for school and stuff, but he's also training there. He was given some vault tips, and he has the same kind of issues as me on vault, and he told me the tips he was given. So today, we're gonna try those tips. Hopefully they work. If they don't work today, we're gonna just keep trying them. Usually when I get a tip or I give myself a tip or something, I'll just try it for like a day, and if it doesn't work, we'll move on. But he showed me that this tip worked for him within the span of one day, going from a mediocre vault, I don't know, like it was okay vault, to like just super good vault, you know, just in one day. So we're gonna give this as long as it takes to work. Clearly it works, and I just need to figure out how to make it work. So yeah, let's warm up with handsprings and some round offs, and then we'll go for the real vaults and we'll see how well it works. But the main part of the tip he gave me was to run quicker. And when I aim for the beepboard over there, right there, instead of like hurling and jumping really high into it, I just dive into it. So then me jumping forward leaves my chest back instead of me jumping into it. Having my chest forward and collapsing on the table, my chest will be back, which will fly me up, hopefully. We're gonna give her a go and fix my vault today. Okay, so yeah, let's get started. Handspring number one. Handspring number two. Okay, now for the round offs. We're gonna just do a full to start. He said he started working one and a half twists, and, you know, finishing facing that way. I usually just do full. We're gonna slowly get into working one and a half, so then I can work on like finishing like that. So when I do two and a half twist, it finishes like that. But I usually just do full because it finishes there, where my double twist finishes there. Yeah, we're gonna kind of try the trick this turn. I'm still not like fully warmed up. So yeah, those handsprings before, I wasn't trying the new tip he gave me because the handsprings are just to warm up my run and my punch and stuff. But now we're gonna kinda try the tip. And hopefully after this turn here, we like really go for an actual turn and we're like warmed up enough. So yeah, round off number one. Okay, I just tried the tactic there. It worked. I definitely wasn't running fast enough or punching. I wasn't doing anything hard enough because I'm still not like warmed up enough. I could feel it. I could feel it. I flipped quicker. I felt myself flipping quicker. And especially for a turn where it's supposed to be just really crappy and, you know, not max power. Not bad. So we're gonna go for another full. I feel warmed up enough that I should be able to actually run full speed, punch full power. So the tactic should hopefully really work on this turn. So yeah, let's give her a go. Round off number two. It's like magic, holy. Okay, I just watched back. Let's be real. Let's go through the last 100 and whatever many days of my vault sessions and find a better full than that, okay? I don't think I've ever done a better full than that. Probably done like cleaner ones and better landings or whatever, but the rotation of that, never that fast, okay? So thank you, Yanni. Everyone comment, thanks, Yanni. Because he changed my vault, I think. And all that, the only thing I was really like picturing on the turn to like make it better was just the one thing he kind of told me was when I'm going to that that beatboard there, instead of hurtling up and then kind of killing all my power, was to just run fucking like full speed at it and then just like jump straight into it. And then when I jumped straight into it, the thing was, it's supposed to give me no time to like bend my knees to like push up. It's like hitting my legs straight on and just getting max power off it immediately. So I felt like that worked. I could see how it could work better for 1.5 and 2.5 twists, because it's kind of really rotating you. So to finish the flip like that, it's better than to like what I'm doing where I'm trying to like finish downwards like this. But yeah, that is deadly. So keep her going here. Let's try a double twist now, and hopefully I can keep the tactic the same and I don't go back to my old stupid habits and I can just keep doing the same tip that I was given. So yeah, double twist now. All right, double twist number one. That was still not bad, but like I messed it up, so it wasn't good. I kind of like fell completely into the table. This is the table, by the way, for non-gymnasts. That's what we call the table. I kind of just collapsed into it instead of hitting it, so I kind of killed everything. But I still managed to not completely die, so clearly this trick I think is working. All right, just watch back. The fact that I was still able to land on my feet, good sign. That's a good sign right there. But I'm gonna be honest with you guys, my Achilles are absolutely sloshed, and we still got floor in the afternoon, and we got vault and floor again tomorrow. So since we have vault again tomorrow, and again on Thursday, and again on Friday, no need to do a crazy amount today. I just wanna hit one, I'm gonna do one or two more. Unless this next one's good, then we'll finish on that. Cause I just kinda wanna do one good one where I can go home and just rewatch it over and over and over to see what I did differently as compared to the turn that I just did, to compare crap and good, so I can see what the little differences are. Cause that's the whole point of these videos, is for me to go home and just rewatch and study what I'm doing wrong and right. So yeah, if the next two are bad, we'll still be finished. Cause I did one good full, so I'm still able to study that and see what I did correct there as compared to these double twists. So yeah, double twist number two. I'm gonna be honest, that turn was still pretty bad, but it's freaking way better than it used to be. So yep, thanks again to Yanni. The tip definitely worked. I just gotta figure out how to make it work a little better. I feel like if I did some more vault today, it would improve a bunch more, but I'd rather go home, you know, just study it instead and like rewatch it instead of abusing my legs. It's my ankles and Achilles. It's mainly the Achilles. You know, it's my whole legs. They're just trash. I don't know why. We only got two events that are legs in the sport, and then four of the ones are upper body, and my legs are just ruined. I don't get why. But yeah, this was a good vault session, so good stuff. Let's go do some landings now. And yep, landings. All right, one stick of everything. Okay, that's it for landings. Almost everything first try. Okay, now it is time for pommel horse. Pommel horse in the morning. Yeah, love it. Gotta love it. It's so much fun. Yep, nice. All right, pommel. Before I even start, I just wanna make the plan so I can't change the plan. One hit routine. If it's hit clean, we're done. If it's hit kind of sloppy, then we work a few skills after. Or worst case scenario, we just attempt three routines. Okay, so yeah, there's the plan. So yeah, let's go to pommel, shall we? All right, give about two warm-up turns. We're gonna go for the routine now. So yeah, hopefully I can just hit a nice clean first try, or like pretty clean. If it's like pretty clean, we'll finish on the first one. So routine number one. Should have fallen about three times there. Don't know how I stayed up. All right, I watched the routine back. It's actually not too bad. The reason I made a little grunt noise during the Magyar were the one where I just kind of travel forward across from side, then up, down, you know? That one's called Magyar, when I'm going forward, up, down. Made a little grunt noise because when I stepped up, kind of was falling backwards, but still managed to like pull it forward. So yeah, like a few points in the routine where I almost fell. And for the gymnasts that watch these videos, if you're wondering why I like explain skills, why I've recently started explaining skills a little bit, is because there's a non-gymnast out there that watch this, and then there's non-gymnast parents of kids that go to the gym here that watch this. So then at least when their kids get older or their kids start to do skills and stuff, they can kind of have an understanding of the skills, because my dad still has no idea what any of the skills are. Yeah, like when I tell him, oh, I caught, you know, Kovacs Coleman Gaylord today, the triple connection, he's like, just send the video. So yeah, for all the parents that are watching these, I'm trying to help you out a bit, so when your kid gets older, if they decide to pursue the sport as long as I have, you can know what they're talking about a little bit when it gets to that point. But yeah, polymer 2 wasn't bad. We're gonna go for one more, hit or not, then we're done. So yeah, one more polymer routine and then we'll call her quits for first training here. We'll come back for another beautiful second training with 4 events. That'll be deadly. All right, polymer routine number 2. Let's go. Oh, that one was clean as a mofo, okay? Deadly. You know, still a little bit of form break, obviously, but the whole point of doing palm in the morning like this is because I knew it would have issues, so I wanted to make it harder, so I had a way to improve my palm. So I put a struggle, you know, a little path block, if you want to say, to help me improve my palm, making it harder in training, so when competition comes, it'll be a slice of cake, you know? A little piece of heaven when comp comes. I'm just trying to make my training so hard right now to the point where when it's competition time, it'll pretty much be like a relaxation vacation trip for me. That's why I'm working so hard. So then the only thing I have to worry about is like, oh, I just gotta hit a routine, but I only gotta do one today, you know? So yeah, second routine, pretty clean. Little bits of form break and stuff, you know, but all in all, pretty good for doing a routine at like 10 in the morning. So yeah, I'm gonna go home, have some rice and eggs, and then we'll come back for second training. So that's the end of first training. See you guys in second training. All right, welcome back to the gym. Welcome to second training. We're gonna start on floor, so let's get started.
Oh my God!
I'm gonna take it high, yeah, okay. Let them slide, yeah. That shit wasn't quiet.
Let's do it again. I do a few triple twists and we're done. I got 4 again tomorrow. I got it again on Thursday. I got it again on Friday, okay? 2 more triple twists and then we're done. One last one. That's all I ask. same place, I'ma keep that nick up somewhere in between. Okay, we're gonna finish on that. Probably should have finished three turns ago. Good stuff. Yeah, let's go to P Bars now, shall we? All right, welcome to P Bars. Let's get started. Alright, I'm warmed up, ready to go. Let's go for a P-Bar routine now. Full P-Bar routine. P-Bar routine number one.
Hey vlog, welcome back. So today we're on trim.
Yes.
And P-Bars.
Welcome back.
So today our turn.
Ashton's gonna stick his routine.
Ashton's gonna probably stick his routine.
Hey guys, so I got a new phone, and it's this one, and it's so preppy, and I'm famous, because I'm like being famous, and then this is my wallpaper, it's me and my cousin, and it's really preppy. Okay, bye.
Extra dismount. Good stuff, hopefully you guys said kind words.
I did,
that was a good routine, guys. Other than the peach and the dismount, everything was good. Yeah, peach, the first thing I do. Okay, we're gonna go for another full routine. This time we're gonna add giant at the start, so we're just gonna do it from swing, because it hurts my shoulder to hang, so I don't wanna start from handstand. And then, yeah, the rest of everything else. So routine number two. Okay, that was a good routine. Oh no, it wasn't. It was good endurance. The first routine was good-ish for the most part, other than the peach and dismount. Second routine, giant was good, peach was alright. Palm and I caught like that instead of there, so that's kind of why it messed up. But yeah, all good endurance. Two extra dismounts for three. I don't really know. I was zoned out for those dismounts. I was just kind of on autopilot, just trying to get a good one done. It was either two or three extra ones. But yeah, that's good for P bars. Two routines, deadly. Let's go to high bar now, shall we? All right, time for high bar. So let's get started. Hopefully it feels good and we can go for a routine or two. Same kind of training we did on Saturday, you know? One full routine and one half routine with the stoop full and stuff. So yeah, let's get going.
Six or seven. No, it was the strip. It was arm players with, you know.
30th.
You're a party animal, Caleb.
My turn was, it was good for the most part. You know, second turn, not bad. That was a technically full routine. I just missed the endo and the staller. So yeah, solid second turn. We're gonna go for routine again, but this time with the stoop full at the beginning and actually start the routine how it's supposed to be started. Cause it's not supposed to start with Coleman. It's supposed to start with endo. So yeah, routine number two-ish.
Where it's red, man. It hurts right in here. Yes, I know. That's why I think it's my lip notes.
Oh, not bad, dude.
When I put cats on my lip notes. Yeah.
That was really good. God, I'm just on a roll today. Good stuff. Oh, good stuff. Eyebrows been really good. Beaver's been really good. Floor was still good. I was just mad out of, not anger, but so much like pain. I just need to release that like energy, you know? So I wasn't actually mad on floor. Floor was good. Palm and ball this morning, we're good. I don't know, I'm talking about all this now. Since I'm talking about all this now, I'm not gonna talk about it at the end of the video. But everything's been good. I'm gonna do we got hybrid again tomorrow. So there's no reason to keep doing more stuff. And I got hybrid again the next day, and the next day, and the next day, and the next day, and the next day. So we're just, let's go to rings. So yeah, let's go to rings now. It's good. All right, we're gonna do a few more sets of that because it's so much fun. Yeah, let's keep going. No way he doesn't do the neck thing. There's no way. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're done rings. That felt, yep, we're done rings. Last turn was good. We got this beautiful rip here. As I said at the beginning of the video, it was time to bleed. I meant it literally. And yep, good training. We're not going over all my training stuff because I, for some reason, did that right after high bar. Don't know why. But yep, today was a great day. Good progress. I don't know. I pretty much did 2 on 6, except for rings. Yeah, good day. So that's the end of the video. If you watched the full video, enjoy it. Glad to hear that. If you watched the full video, comment the word pie, P-I-E. Bye, love you.